Chauncey along one cardinal direction to repeat forever. After this first Chauncey is calculated, a second Chauncey is actually calculated, which I'm going to call for the remainder of this video the population Chauncey. This one cannot be broken in the same manner as before. You cannot force the random number generated by long A or long B within the population Chauncey to return zero ever. But why? Well, this part of the population Chauncey's equation forces the returned result to be an odd number, which zero is not. But you're watching this video, so clearly there is a way to break it. In order to break the population Chauncey equation, we need to force B to equal A, or B to equal negative A. Let me explain why that breaks this equation. Excluding the main world seed, this is the equation we're dealing with. Position X is the x-coordinate of any given chunk within the world, and position Z is the z-coordinate of any given chunk. Those are fixed values based on the location of that chunk. So, if we can force B and A to be equals, watch what happens to the equation. Let's pretend that both A and B are equal to 69. Nice. Let's also assume we're testing the chunk at position 1, negative 1, which means x position 1 and z position negative 1. Well, 1 times 69 is 69, and negative 1 times 69 is negative 69. Add them together, and you get 0. If the x position is 2, and the z position is negative 2, same thing. 2 times 69 is 138. Negative 2 times 69 is negative 138. Add them together, 0. If A and B are opposites, instead of the x and z position being opposites, the same thing occurs. But where both x and z are positive numbers this time. 1 times 69 is 69, and 1 times negative 69 is negative 69. Add them together, you get